I just don't understand how two people can dirty so many dishes. Seems like the minute I get through with one stack, there's another. I tell you, John Bickerson, I'm not going to stand for this much longer. Every one of my friends has made at least one day out of... John! John Bickerson! How can you fall asleep at the breakfast table?
It ain't easy with all that talking going on. Wake me in 5 minutes, Blanche.
No, you don't. You just get busy and help out.
I'm tired, Blanche.
That's just an excuse. Did you ever see that sweet young couple next door? Now, there's a husband for you. He waits on her hand and foot.
He's an idiot.
He never lets her do anything alone. On Monday, he washed the dishes with her. On Tuesday, he cleaned the silver with her. On Wednesday, he ironed the clothes with her. What do you suppose he did on Thursday?
He mopped up the floor with her.
He did not.
Well, he should have. Listen, Blanche, I got enough problems of my own, and I'm not interested in that stupid couple next door.
Can't even get you to do the simplest chore.
I do plenty.
I begged you to have the electric orange squeezer fixed. Did you take it to the electrician? No.
Well, I didn't have to. I fixed it myself.
How could you fix it? It needed a new motor.
I hooked it up to the vacuum cleaner.
Vacuum cleaner? Does it work?
It works fine. Except it sucks up the juice and spits the pits in your face. What time is it?
You've got plenty of time. I'll have breakfast ready in a minute.
I don't want any more. This oatmeal is plenty.
What oatmeal? Where'd you get oatmeal?
What kind of talk is that? It was on the top of the stove. I ate the whole pot.
That wasn't oatmeal. That was wallpaper paste.
Oh, no.
You promised to paper the bathroom this morning.
Wallpaper paste.
Now, how are you going to put the wallpaper up?
I'll lick it in place. How can you worry about wallpaper when I'm practically poisoned?
Oh, you're not poisoned. It's just flour and water. Go take an antidote and I'll whip up a nice omelet.
I'm not hungry anymore.
Don't be like that, John. I've already got the powdered eggs on. Now all I have to do is chop up the turnips and peel the frog legs. It's a wonderful dish.
I'm not eating any powdered frog's legs.
Just taste it. That's all I ask.
Not me. First time I ever saw green eggs.
That's from the skunk cabbage. I got the recipe from my mother.
It looks like your mother.
What did you say?
Nothing. Look, Blanche, I'm just getting tired of these outlandish dishes you keep making.
Like what?
Like that rhubarb pie you made yesterday.
What was the matter with it?
Matter with it? Who ever heard of a pie 2 feet long?
Well, I couldn't get any shorter rhubarb.
Let's have an understanding now, Blanche. I hate rhubarb, and stop making me 7-layer broccoli cakes and sheep soup.
I never made sheep soup in my life. It's good, healthy possum broth.
Yes, possum broth.
Yes, possum broth. Just because I have a little imagination in cooking is no reason you should pick on me.
I'm not picking, Blanche.
Why don't you come out and say it? You hate my cooking.
I don't hate it. I just don't understand it.
You hate it.
I tell you, I don't hate it.
You do.
Don't I eat everything you make?
Then why do you always get ptomaine poisoning?
I'm not gonna figure that one. Blanche, do you mind if I get dressed and go to work?
I don't care what you do. Get dressed.
I will as soon as you finish wiping the dishes with my shirt.
Well, you shouldn't have hung it in the towel rack.
Where else could I hang it? You made me sleep in the kitchen, didn't you?
I didn't know my sister Clara was coming to spend the night, and I can't help it if we only have one bedroom. Fold up your cot.
Fine place to sleep, on a cot in the kitchen.
Now, what's wrong with it?
There isn't enough room in here to swing a cat.
You leave the cat alone.
I never touch the cat.
Plenty of room in here.
There is not.
There is too. If you'd put the breakfast table on top of the refrigerator and the canary cage in the washing machine, then you could shove the stove in the doorway and you'd have plenty of room for the cot between the sink and the cat's sandbox.
I tried that. The cot's too short. My head lopped over into the sink and that leaky faucet gave me an all-night shampoo.
Well, you should have worn a shower cap. Anyway, Clara's gone now and you won't have to sleep in the kitchen tonight.
Fine.
I felt terrible about her leaving before having any breakfast.
She didn't need any breakfast. She was in here 14 times last night for a snack.
Well, what of it? Nothing disturbs you when you're sleeping.
Well, she did. She had the refrigerator open so much, I woke up with frostbitten feet. Woman eats like a boa constrictor.
Clara doesn't eat because she wants to. Just because she's trying to get rid of her heartburn.
Oh, sure. Where are my shoes?
You're wearing them. You're a fine one to talk about other people stuffing themselves. A man who can't even see his own shoes anymore. Do you want this frog omelet or not?
No. Stop using my pants for a pot holder.
Well, that's what you use them for.
Just leave my pot out of this. I may have a little flab around my waistline, but I don't eat one-tenth as much as your fat sister.
You stop calling her fat. Clara's a glandular case. The doctor says she's an ectomorph with an overactive thyroid.
I don't care. She's a convertible with a hydromatic drive. She eats like she was condemned.
If you say one more word against my sister, I'll never talk to you again.
I wish you wouldn't tempt.